U.S. Ambassador to the U.N. Nikki Haley getting a first-hand look on the ground in South Sudan, trying to prevent Africa's next safe haven for terrorists. Weeks after the ISIS ambush in Niger that killed four Americans.
A government that's ignoring its people leads to conflict, and we're seeing that situation deteriorate. And what happens is when that conflict hits, it also becomes a breeding ground for extremist groups, and that's what we don't want.
A sentiment echoed by the top U.S. commander in Africa, Thomas Waldhauser, who in Africa this week with Haley said, quote, "With all the challenges, with the youth bulge, the poverty, the lack of governance, the wide open spaces, these are areas where extremists like ISIS or Al-Qaeda thrive." Haley warned President Salva Kiir his actions in the brutal civil war risk seeing his own country descend into chaos.
The United States has invested a lot in South Sudan, and they've invested a lot in him. Over $11 billion was invested into a country, and this isn't what we asked for in return. We didn't ask for rapes. We didn't ask for people to be fearful of their government. We didn't ask for the hunger. We didn't ask for all of the violence that's happening. And so it was a tough message of, we need this to be fixed.
With 4 million people displaced from their homes, South Sudan's refugee crisis is being compared to that of the Rwandan genocide. Devastation Haley witnessed at a refugee camp in neighboring Ethiopia, where hundreds of thousands have fled the violence. Peacekeepers guard this protection camp in South Sudan's capital, Juba, where the cries of "down with Kiir" and "Kiir is a killer" are mixed with "welcome Donald Trump" and pleas for U.S. help. Haley was forced to leave the camp when the protests grew intense. But the ISIS ambush of U.S. forces in Niger has put in sharp focus how a region riddled with political chaos, violence, and famine draws extremists that can threaten the U.S. The terror threat the U.S. is facing in Africa is immense. In Somalia, the U.S. military is helping local forces defeat al-Shabaab, which is responsible for many terror attacks. General Waldhauser saying, quote, "In places like the Sahel, in places like Somalia, ISIS continues to look for locations, looks for places to establish itself."
And Nikki Haley told a few reporters traveling with her that unless something is done soon, the children affected by the conflict are going to grow into adults with no future, no job, and resentful of the U.S. for not doing more. That's exactly the kind of people ISIS is looking to recruit, Wolf.